Welcome. In this video, we will be showing how the cassava can be cultivated. Tapioca cultivation is quite abundant in southern part of India. It's famous because of ease in cultivation and the workload is minimum. Tapioca is known by many names in many countries like cassava, kappakilangu, mandioca. It grows in tropical areas and the demand is high. Tapioca with the scientific name of Manigat esculenta and it belongs to the family Euphorbiaceae. The plant is woody and erect stem with spirally arranged leaves. The plant produces petalless flowers on raceme. The cassava plant is common in the tropics and is adapted to the hot conditions of the tropical lands. It is one of the most drought tolerant crop that is capable of growing in marginal soils. These are some of the varieties of cassava. Among these, Sriharsha is the most popular variety in cassava. There are different types of tapioca plant varieties, single stem variety and branched stem variety. Tapioca is rich in carbohydrates, the main source of diet in tropics. It is the good source of energy. In India, tapioca is cultivated in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Meghalaya, and Nagaland. Nigeria is the world's largest producer of cassava. Climate and soil. Cassava is tropical root crop. It requiring at least 8 months of warm weather to produce a crop. It does not tolerate freezing conditions. Red laterite soil is best suited for tapioca cultivation. The range of the soil pH is 4.5 to 8. Cassava is mostly propagated through vegetatively stem cuttings by planting a piece of stalk. The first step in cassava cultivation is to prepare the tapioca sticks from the last harvest. The tapioca stem is cut into small pieces with one or two nodes using a cutter for precision. In order to make better stacks, the stacks should be obtained from the middle portion of the stem. The second step in cassava cultivation is to prepare the soil. So, the land is tilled to mix the organic matter into the soil. It also helps to control the weed and the break up the soil. Prior tillage is required for the high yield. The soil is divided into raised beds with gaps in between to pass the water. The sticks are then planted vertically at the depth of 5 cm and the soil is poured above it. The sticks are planted with a given distance uniformly. It is then watered. Avoid the deep planting. It results in swelling of the stem. The number of the seeds required for planting per hectare is vary between rain-fed and irrigated condition. Manures and fertilizers. The recommended for improved varieties is basal dose of 15 tons of farmyard manure and the chemical fertilizers like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. As a basal dosage of 45:90:120 kg per hectare in irrigated condition. We can also add ash because it contains potash. Also covering the soil with dead leaves, it will create a layer of humus that can provide the needed nutrients. Tapioca requires water during the first 3 weeks of growth and it is often grown in the month of June-July. Cassava is cultivated under both irrigated and rain-fed conditions. Under irrigated condition, it can be cultivated throughout the year. In rain-fed condition, May-June is best time for the cultivation. In drought condition, frequent irrigation is needed. After few days of planting, we can also plant leguminous plants in between the crops. It helps fixate the nitrogen. Tapioca is prone to weeds during initial stage of the growth. Hence, regular weeding must be carried out. Some farmers are also practice mulching using leaves. It is the best way to achieving weed control, and it also preserves soil moisture. Cassava mosaic and cassava bacterial blight is common disease found in cassava. The common pest is mites and white flies. Integrated pest management practices can be followed to control the pest attack. The time of harvest is also crucial factor for high yield. The crop can be harvested at 9 to 11 months after planting. Harvest usually done by hands, and each plant has 30 kg of tapioca. During tuber maturity, the leaves become yellow and 50% of the leaves become dried and shed off. Yield is depend on various factors like farm management, climatic conditions and cultivar chosen. For example, from this chart, the effect of irrigation on cassava yield, the cassava root yield will be high under the full irrigation condition compared to the rain-fed condition. For high-yielding varieties, the yield will be around 30 to 40 tons per hectare. In short-duration crop, the yield is 25 to 30 tons per hectare. Starch is extracted from the roots of the cassava plant in powder form. The cassava starch, flour, gari, cassava chips are the main end products of cassava roots. Thank you.